Yes, it's the show where teams of comedians compete to prove who knows the most about comedy. It's a knockout competition, and we are at the semi-final stage. So, tonight, we are welcoming back the teams who successfully battled their way through their first round clashes. So let's get reacquainted. On my right is a team that won through in the heat, despite the fact that if they were together and come dine with me, they wouldn't make it through to pudding on a Monday. It's Jason Manford, Nicholas Parsons, and Paul Chowdhury! And to my left, a team that roared into the semi-finals. I say roared, one of them squeaked. It's Armin Gilili, Daniel Sloss, and Joe Pasquale! We are lucky enough to have more than 100 years of comedy know-how on each of our teams tonight, but we're in the semi-finals now. So eyes down, everyone. From here on, it's all about the points. Let's get started. This round is called The Year in Question. Jason, Paul, and Nicholas, you're up first. Take a look at this. Everything you see and hear relates to one particular year.
Have you ever been trapped in a loveless marriage with a woman you despised?
Phew, not since I was 9.
Yes, I do know what is a family. First of all, there is your mum and dad, and they are 20 old and £1. And your dad is older than your mum, and he is allowed to make her cry. And your mum is allowed to make your dad cross, for because the vicar said so. And you are borned out of them by kissing and jumping.
She takes no interest in my friends, you know? She laughs at my peanuts, hobbies. She doesn't even value my crinkle-cut cheesy watsit.
This is the Majestic Hotel. What's majestic about it?
There's a damp patch on that wall that looks just like King Juan Carlos of Spain.
This hotel is a microcosm of all that is wrong with this godforsaken country as we limp towards the 21st century.
Well, it's Cow's Week, isn't it? It's the only place that's got a vacancy.
I wonder why. Did Mr. and Mrs. Bedbug have to cancel?
So, talk me through what you saw. 1 point for correctly identifying the theme song you heard, another for getting the year right. Just to be clear, for the TV shows, it's the year they started that I'm interested in.
Well, the music was The Simpsons.
1 point straight up.
That one, no problem.
We didn't know that.
And then, what do we have? We had, what was the first programme up?
A little bit of Fry and Laurie.
Oh, that's right, Fry and Laurie.
Which, I was in one of those episodes, yes. Hugh Laurie sang a song to me and I didn't move. I think it was a payoff. No, I put a payoff in it. They didn't like it. They said, no, we don't want any words from you, Nicholas. I love Lucy.
Yes, of course, Lucy
Ball. Lucy Ball passed away in this year, yes.
Did you ever meet her?
No, I didn't. I met most of them, but not her.
No.
Anyway, she was in America. I was in this country. And...
She might have travelled.
There was planes back then. I don't know what that show's called, but that was Morwenna Banks.
Yes.
Doing, And then the last one was Birds of a Feather.
Birds of a Feather,
yes. A favourite, Jason?
What was weird, actually, is I felt like I was getting a bit of, like, nostalgia from watching that terrible hotel that they were in. I stayed in one once. That was run by... It was basically a bloke's house where he had a spare room. And, but he put vacancies on his front window. I thought, all right, it'll be okay. And I went in and I said, he was the grumpiest man in the world. It cost £12 to stay there. And I said, what time's breakfast? And he said, any time between 9 and 10 past. I had a 10-minute opportunity on my breakfast.
It's pretty depressing.
Well, when
isn't it?
I first started, we didn't stay in hotels. We couldn't afford them.
Well,
we stayed in digs, professional digs.
Yeah.
And there was a professional digs list which was sent out by Equity. There was one digs I was in, and the wonderful landlady, she came from our country, from where you did. She said, right now, she said, you're up there. She said, but the toilet's very noisy, so we don't want you to use the toilet at night. So you got a chamber pot under the bed there. But one thing we have to ask you, if you use it, don't put it back there because it rusts the springs.
Oh, wow.
The steam.
Oh, God, that's awful.
Because I've been in some depressing hotels, and I remember I called up the... I couldn't open the window, so I phoned up room service. I said, I can't open the window. I said, don't worry, we have air conditioning. so I can't jump out the bloody air conditioner.
So we are still looking for a year.
Oh, a year, right, yes.
Say around 90 or late 80s.
Yeah.
1989-ish.
I'll join you.
Okay,
I'm going for 88, but I'll join you on 89.
We're going to go 89.
1989 is the correct answer. Yes. The Simpsons started in 1989. Bart Simpson's voice is actually done by Nancy Cartwright, a woman who coincidentally also does Joe's voice.
You know, when I was little, only dogs could hear me talk when I was little.
Yeah. We saw Morwenna Banks there in Absolutely. Absolutely was like the Andy Murray of sketch shows. British when it was brilliant, Scottish when it was rubbish. Here are a couple of bonus questions for you, Jason's team. These are worth 1 point each. We showed you a clip of Birds of a Feather. At the end of the final series, where does Tracy give birth?
Well, through a vagina, I would have thought.
Well, factually correct,
yes.
I think, but I presume you want a location rather than a...
I'm looking for a location, the place where Tracy gives birth.
Now, I think...
At the end of Birds of a Feather.
I think it was a Christmas episode, and I think it was a stable.
Is the correct answer.
Yes.
Yes. Birds of a Feather, Leslie Joseph. What's two after Cougar? Here's another question for you. The Simpsons got their own series in 1989. I think you're going to know this. On which show did they first appear?
That was the Tracy Ullman Show.
The Tracy Ullman Show. That's absolutely correct. 1 point. After a few years, The Simpsons was in decline. But in 2000, it really got funny again when it changed its name to Family Guy. Omid, Daniel and Joe, your turn. Take a look at this. Try and work out the year in question. Bang.
Anyway, Ben Elton, can you believe it?
I'm knowing it great. Is he famous?
Oh, Linda, you really make me laugh.
That's because I'm naturally funny. Do you know, sometimes I walk down the street and people just burst out laughing. Here, Marilyn Monroe was the same. Only she was a bit big around the hip. Fat cow.
So, Omid's team, talk me through what you saw. 1 point for correctly identifying the theme that was playing, another for getting the year right.
Okay, the theme.
I know the theme.
Do you? I recognise it, but I don't want it.
Yeah, it was like a dark sitcom. It was League of Gentlemen, I think.
It was League of Gentlemen, well, yes, 1 point.
Yeah. The year.
First one was Spaced.
Spaced with Simon Pegg, yeah.
So, and then...
Then it was South Park.
South Park, which...
South Park the movie, I think.
South Park the movie.
Yeah, well, the movie, not the series.
Yeah.
It's, I know it just from 9 years old. I snuck in to see it, South Park with my dad.
Ah.
So I was nine, so 1999.
We're going to go with that? 1999.
Is absolutely the correct answer. was indeed 1999, and we heard the music from The League of Gentlemen there. The show featured a dark collection of grotesque characters, very much the Loose Women of its day. The series Spaced had millions of obsessive fans thanks to its sci-fi in-jokes and references. For example, to Star Trek's Dr. Spock. I know he's called Mr. Spock, by the way. Just wanted to hear the internet exploding. Smack the Pony was a groundbreaking all-female comedy programme which changed the landscape of British television. As a result, it's rare nowadays to find a show without at least 50% women. Where's David Walliams when you need him? What is the origin of the name of the fictional village in The League of Gentlemen?
It's Royston Vasey.
Royston Vasey, which is the name of Roy Choppy Brown.
Is the correct answer. Roy Choppy Brown is possibly Britain's most sexist, racist and homophobic comic. If you haven't seen him, congratulations. Here's another for you. We saw an extract from Gimme Gimme Gimme. At the end of the series, James Dreyfus's character Tom finally leaves the flat in order to join the cast of which TV soap?
Emmerdale.
Should we go in Emmerdale?
Or I'm just Hollyoaks, Omnibus, or the late one that's now awful. I don't know what it is. I imagine it wasn't out then.
Hollyoaks, maybe Hollyoaks.
I'm literally guessing. No, I think Hollyoaks is
1999 Hollyoaks.
Oh yeah. Yeah, I forgot this wasn't a question about this year. Sorry.
Oh, he left that in
1999.
No, you're right. Maybe.
It was Crossroads.
Oh. What?
So, at the end of that round, the scores are as follows. Omen has 3, Jason has 4. Join us after the break, but I'll leave you to puzzle over this. Which of our panellists tonight once upset the great Bette Midler by asking to have their photograph taken with her? Welcome back to Comedy World Cup. Before the break, I asked you which of our panellists tonight once upset the great Bette Midler by asking to have their photograph taken with her. Let's find out who that was, shall we? Bette Midler? Any Bette Midler fans? Jason? Our audience is aghast.
I know. I was also aghast.
What? Were you a big fan of Bette?
It was the Royal Variety Show in 2009, and all day we'd been getting, because we were excited, there were so many massive celebrities on. There was all, you know, Michael Bublé and Whoopi Goldberg and just proper stars, like, finally. No offence. But they were, like, proper. And Paddy McGuinness, me and Paddy McGuinness were having like, a bit of a rivalry, who could get the best photo. And I said, I really want to get Bette Midler's photo, because my mum's a massive fan. So I went over, I'd seen her in the corner, he'd spotted her first, so have a look over there, it's only Bette Midler. And, so I thought, I'll go have a, let the mouse see the cheese, or whatever. And I thought, so I went over, and yeah, and I just said, Miss Midler, because I'm a nice boy, I said, Miss Midler, can I have a photo with you? My mum's a huge fan, and I liked, you know, Beaches and First Wives Club, and, you know, all that. And, she went a bit mad. Like, she was only about that big, and she's digging me in the chest, and you're going, are you serious? Who are you? Coming over here and asking me, you know, we're going to go on stage and perform for the Queen. I was like, in 5 hours? Yeah, we're going. And, yeah, anyway, maybe she was nervous about the show. I don't know what it was. Anyway, the worst thing was that it all happened in front of all the other comics who thought it was hilarious. None of them were laughing harder than Paddy McGuinness. because about half an hour before I'd done it, he'd seen someone else do it as well.
On to our next round. This is the young one. We'll start with you this time, Omid, Daniel and Joe. We're going to play a clip of a young person performing a stand-up routine made famous by a well-known comedian. All you have to do for your point is tell me whose routine you think young Dylan here is performing.
I wanted a basic Hoover and the bloke in the shop tried to sell me one with variable suction power. Has it ever occurred to you to have anything less than full power when you're hoovering? Think about it. Does it ever occur to you to have anything less than full power when you're hoovering? It seems a shame to get rid of all this dust, doesn't it? If only there was a way of getting rid of the top layer. That's all I want to do. If only there was a Hoover that could get rid of the top layer and leave the rest for next week's hoovering. That's the plan.
Yeah.
clearly, it's a kid, and also the ethnicity is meant to throw us off, so that's clearly
maybe not
Paul Chowdhury.
I don't know. I
could it be Mickey Flanagan, or...?
No, I think Mickey's a bit, you know, London geezer, ooh, that was a bit rant. I would guess, like, maybe Rod Gilbert?
Yeah, I think you're right. I think there was a bit of venom behind that as well, which obviously like, the kid was trying to...
The way you were saying it was very... Rod, you know, repeats things angrily, and that's where it comes from, just because he gets worked up over very small things, and that, obviously, getting annoyed.
I think
Hoover.
That's a very intelligent... If that's a guess, that's an intelligent guess.
You going to go for Rod Gilbert?
What do you think?
Yeah, I've got no idea.
We are going Rod Gilbert.
Let's have a look.
I wanted a basic Hoover. The bloke in the
there
shop tried to sell me one with variable suction. Has it ever occurred to you to have anything less than full power when you're hoovering? Think about it. Has it ever occurred to you to have anything less than full power? Hey, seems a shame to get rid of all this dust, doesn't it? If only there was some way of just getting rid of the top layer. That's all I want to do. Have you got a hoover that can just get rid of the top bit and then I can leave some for next week's hoovering? That's the plan.
Very well done. It was Rod Gilbert. Welshman Rod was born in Llanfai Pwch Gwyngich o Gerig Gwyn Drobo Clenty Silio Gogogoch. It wasn't really, I just wanted to show off. That was 2 days well spent. Over to you, Jason, Paul and Nicholas. Whose stand-up is Leah performing here?
In 1998, you never had Sky Plus or Sky HD. It was just Sky. And you had three options. You could get it via a satellite dish, via a cable, or you knew a guy that could get you a box. You know one of those guys that can get hold of anything for 40 quid. He can get you a Nissan Micra, 40 quid. He can get you a set of golf clubs, 40 quid, an iPod Nano, 40 quid, 50 quid in cash, 40 quid. Yeah.
Very talented Leah there, but whose act was she aping?
Obviously, it's an Indian comedian.
Well, it was weird. She started off like, I thought, oh, it sounds like a Peter Kay, or like she's trying to mimic him a little bit. She's, and then, but I think she's Welsh, isn't she? Because I heard a Nissan Micra coming in there at one point.
I think the truth is she's stabbing for a regional accent there. She may be slightly wandering around the country, but that's what she's going for.
It was like a little wander around the UK.
I don't think the comedian she's taking off is a North Country comedian.
No, no, I don't think so.
Sounds very ranty.
It sounds working class.
Very working class, very, without being offensive, Scottish. No offence.
Oh, yes. Awkward!
And I'd say it's not. It's someone who's, you know, into Sky, so obviously a younger act.
Yeah.
Someone more around your kind of age group, Kevin Bridges.
Kevin Bridges.
We'll go with that.
We're going Kevin Bridges?
Yes.
Let's have a look.
In 1998.
There you go.
1998, you never had Sky Plus or Sky HD. It was just Sky. And you had, I'd say, three options. You could get it via a satellite dish, via a cable, or you knew a guy that could get you a box. You're one of the guys that can get you a hold of anything for 40 quid. It can get you a Nissan Micra, 40 quid. And get you a set of golf clubs, 40 quid. An iPod Nano, 40 quid. 50 quid in cash, 40 quid.
Yes, very well done. It was Kevin Bridges. Leah, who we saw there, is 11 years old. Kevin Bridges is actually only 3 years older, but he did grow up in Glasgow. Where fudge is one of our five a day. So, a quick look at the scores. Omid has 4, Jason has 5. The next round is in the frame, and it's a picture round. I'm going to show you some stills from well-known comedy films, but to make it a wee bit trickier, we've got rid of all the flesh. So, fingers at the ready, teams. Buzz in when you can identify the film. A correct answer wins you a point and the chance to answer a bonus question.
Can you tell me what this film is? Yes, Jason.
American Pie.
Let's see. It's American Pie, yes. Here's your bonus question. In the film, which country was foreign student Nadia from?
I don't know. Do you remember it?
Should we go with Europe?
Yeah, I think so. Yeah. Europe?
Might need to be a little more specific.
Okay.
Russian or...
Yeah, one of the Russians, one of the sort of up that way.
One of the Russians.
one of the Russian type places. You know, like where Borat's from and all that. Up that way.
I'm going to need you to settle somewhere on okay. the continent.
Russia, Poland. I went for Poland first.
All right, we'll go with Poland. Russia. Nicholas thinks Poland.
Poland is the wrong answer.
Oh.
It was the Czech Republic.
Oh, I was wrong.
They
then.
Say Czechoslovakia, but the film was released in 1999, 7 years after the country divided in 1992. Fact, fans. American Pie is a very rude film, and I can't tell you what the American Pie itself refers to. All I can say is, if you're a fan of the Great British Bake Off, give this film a miss. Here's another still. Buzz in if you know what this film is. Yeah, yes, Daniel.
Team America World Police.
Is the correct answer. Here they are. Your bonus question, what is the only thing the Matt Damon puppet can say in Team America?
Matt Damon.
Is the correct answer. Team America there. It's a feature-length Hollywood film which used puppets instead of actors. A chilling vision of the future. Ready on your buzzers? Here's another picture.
Well, I'll be This Is Spinal Tap.
It is. This Is Spinal Tap. There they are.
I've never seen this film. I'm not going to get this. I just saw guitars and...
Well, well done. Yeah, well, you're not going to get the bonus question then. What is special about Spinal Tap guitarist Nigel Tufnel's amplifier?
Oh, I know this! 11. It goes up to 11.
It goes all the way up to 11, yes! Some people do think that Spinal Tap are a real band. They don't realise they're just a joke. Like Dappy and N-Dubs. Quick look at the scores. Jason has 6. Ahmed has 8! More to come after the break, but I'll leave you to ponder this. One of our panellists tonight keeps a life-size model of a velociraptor in their bedroom. But who? Welcome back to Comedy World Cup. Before the break, I revealed that one of our panellists tonight keeps a life-size model of a velociraptor in their bedroom. But I didn't say who. Who's going to own up to that?
I'd say that was Ahmed. It's you, isn't it, Ahmed? You do the whole impression.
No, I'd say Daniel.
It's Daniel!
Okay, first of all, he's not in my bedroom, he's in the living room, because I brought a girl back once when I was drunk. And I forgot I had him. And there is nothing that will turn a girl off more than going, do you want to see my bedroom? Oh, there you go.
There he is. I mean, one feels it is necessary to ask why.
Why not? It's a velociraptor. Why would you not buy it?
I knew it was you straight away because you're the only one without a wife. It would go, there's no way that's going in our house.
Where did you get it from?
France, because I'm online. My mum was sitting there and we were going through, like, my bank and stuff. She's like, okay, you need to put some money aside because you got this coming out, you need to do all this. And then my dad came through and was like, look at this! Look what I found on the internet! And I love my dad more, so... Yeah, I bought, yeah, and he's house-trained as well. There you go.
Do the jaws ever shut?
No, no, he's always.
Are you
happy.
Asking about Daniels? Dad, I'm only kidding.
Okay, thank you very much. Back to the quiz. Our next round is Mind Your Language. In this round, I'm going to show our teams a clip of a well-known British sitcom that has been remade overseas. You'll get a point if you can identify the sitcom, another one if you can tell me which country it was made in. Jason's team, you're up first. Here's your clip.
Seid ihr top da drin?
Du mit deiner Posaune. Das kann man ja nicht überhören. Och.
Was ist denn hier los?
Wieso kannst du nicht klingeln wie jeder andere normale Mensch?
Weil die Klingel kaputt ist.
Die soll kaputt sein?
So, which sitcom was that, and where was that version made?
Definitely recognise the language, because I used to watch a lot of films in German when I was growing up.
Yeah. I can imagine. And they had that big Hertha Berlin flag as well, so obviously it's German.
German for 1 point, yes.
Well, he was also, from the look of it, not a very likeable character.
Sounds like you may have an idea.
Yeah, I think it's... and just from her, the wife's clothes, I think he's a German... Alf Garnett, and it's Till Death Us Do Part.
Is the correct answer. Yeah. 2 points. It was the German remake of Till Death Us Do Part called Ein Herz und eine Seele, which means one heart and one soul. Don't laugh at my German pronunciation.
I'd like to see more British sitcoms done in Germany. That'd be brilliant. It'd be nice to see a German version of Dad's Army where the arrows go the opposite way.
Here's a bonus question for you. As we saw in the clip, in Ein Herz und eine Seele, Alfred is an avid supporter of the football team Hertha Berlin. But which team does Alf Garnett support in the British version?
West Ham, isn't it?
Go.
West Ham?
Is the correct answer, yes. Till Death Us Do Part was sold to many countries, and Alf Garnett became known around the world for his racism, homophobia and bigotry. Who says we don't export anything anymore? Omid, Daniel and Joe, take a look at this.
E tem correspondência aqui para o lado?
Eu pretendo ter três cartas, uma delas registada.
Acho isso muito estranho.
Pois, mas eu não tenho culpa. Bom dia.
Toda a gente sabe que eu recebo mais correspondência que os vizinhos do lado. Deve haver com certeza um postal da minha irmã, Divisa. Ela já voltou de férias, o postal ainda não chegou, acha normal?
Não, não. Mas também já me tinham dito que aqui nada é normal.
On the scene, what do you reckon?
Well, the way they said normal is a very Eastern European. I'm guessing it's Polish. What do you think, guys? I'm guessing.
I've got no idea of the language, but I'd say the character was a carbon copy of Patricia Rutledge, Mrs. Bouquet, but I've got no idea on the language.
We haven't asked the audience, but that sounds very good.
It sounds positive, doesn't it?
What's the name of that sitcom?
Keeping Up Appearances.
Are you sure? Language.
Yes, it's definitely... Well, it's a carbon copy. The way she was standing as well, everything was copied.
Do you have an idea of the language at all? I'm guessing it's Polish.
It was foreign, so it could be French. I'm just saying it could have been.
I think we're going to go for the name of the sitcom again.
Keeping Up Appearances.
In Polish. In Poland.
Keeping Up Appearances is absolutely right. Yes.
No. I'm used to good with languages.
But I'm afraid it was Portuguese.
No.
It was the Portuguese remake of Keeping Up Appearances. For a bonus point, in Keeping Up Appearances, the actor Geoffrey Hughes played Hyacinth Bouquet's brother-in-law, Onslow. In which film did he play Paul McCartney?
Oh, blimey.
Wow. It'd be a film about the Beatles. I'm going to narrow it down. I'll narrow down and then you guys polish, OK? So it's a film which people are in about the Beatles. Go.
There was a film about the Beatles, wasn't there?
There's been a few, to be fair.
Yeah, but there's one really famous one where they start off in Hamburg and all the gigs they did in Germany. I don't know what it's called, though.
The Beatles.
Is that your final answer?
The Beatles, the movie, yeah.
Beatles, the movie...
Is
not the right answer. He played the voice of Paul McCartney.
I don't know.
Do you know it?
I think it was A Hard Day's Night, wasn't it?
It wasn't Hard Day's Night, no.
I had the actual Beatles.
Was he Yellow Submarine?
It's right, but it's too late. He was the voice of Paul McCartney in the animated movie, Yellow Submarine, yes. So at the end of that round, the teams are tied on 9-all. But there is everything to play for in our next round in the spotlight. Our captains get to nominate one of their team to answer as many questions as they can in 60 seconds on one of these topics listed on the screen. They are British comedy films, Dad's Army, Blackadder, or David Jason. Right, Jason's team, going to start with you. Who do you want to put in the spotlight and what are they going to answer questions on?
Okay, well, we've sort of had a little chat.
Mm-hmm.
I think it's going to have to be me.
Oh, take it on the chin, team captain.
We're going to go with, British comedy films.
British comedy films.
In the last 10 years.
Jason, it's time to go in the spotlight. Jason Manford, you have 60 seconds on British comedy films starting now. The soundtrack to Four Weddings and a Funeral featured which wet hit?
Love Is All Around.
Is the correct answer. In the Simon Pegg, Nick Frost movie Paul, what is Paul?
An alien.
He is. Which British city is the Full Monty set in?
Sheffield.
It is. In what movie does Rowan Atkinson portray a British secret agent?
Oh, Johnny English.
Correct. Who played Bruno in the movie of the same title?
Sacha Baron Cohen.
Correct. In The Pink Panther, what actually is The Pink Panther?
Detective.
No, it's a large pink diamond. Which Shakespeare play does Withnail quote from at the end of Withnail and I?
Hamlet.
Indeed it is. Who plays eight characters in Kind Hearts and Coronet?
David Niven, I don't know.
Alec Guinness.
Alec Guinness, ah!
In Four Lions, which famous Channel 4 prankster stars as the dim-witted Wadge?
Oh, Novak.
I need his whole name.
Kevin Novak.
Kevin Novak's there correct. We go. Which romantic comedy sees Paul Bettany play a washed-up tennis pro?
Oh, Wimbledon.
Yes, it does. And the beginning of that's the end of your 60 seconds. So, Jason, on the subject of British comedy films, you scored a total of 8. Four Weddings and a Funeral is hailed as one of the best British comedy films of all time. A little known fact is that it was a remake of Ken Loach's film, Four Funerals, No Weddings and the Collapse of the British Steel Industry. The British comedy film industry was at its height in the 60s and 70s with the legendary Carry On series. If you've never seen a Carry On film, here it is in kit form. Over to Homage team now. Who is going to go under the spotlight and which of the remaining categories is it to be?
We've had a little chat about this.
Yes.
We're going to put Mr. Pasquale in to talk about David Jason.
Very good. Joe Pasquale, it is time to go in the spotlight.
Okay. Oh, no, shut up. I've had depression here. Look at this light. Is it really necessary like this? I feel like I'm in God's kitchen. He's opened the fridge.
Joe Pasquale, you have 60 seconds.
Does it matter that I don't know nothing about him?
It might be a hindrance, but who knows? Let's see how it rolls.
I'm just covering my back. Go on, off you go.
You have 60 seconds on David Jason starting now. What was the opening line from the Only Fools and Horses theme song?
Oh, pass.
Stick a pony in your pocket. What is the name of Del Boy's local pub?
Oh, the Nag's Head.
Correct. David Jason appeared 3 times as Blanca Webb in which famous sitcom?
Porridge.
He did. What is the name of Del Boy's wife?
Oh, pass.
Raquel. What secret agent rodent does David Jason provide the voice for?
Danger Mouse.
Correct. What actor turned down the part of Del Boy?
Well, I can't remember his name, pass.
It was Jim Broadbent.
Jim Broadbent.
What was David Jason's catchphrase in The Darling Buds of May?
Perfect.
Correct. In which animated TV series did David Jason voice a Transylvanian bird?
Cantacula.
Correct. What type of car does Del Boy arrive in Only Fools and Horses?
A Reliant Robin.
Indeed. Which Welsh Hollywood actress co-stars with Jason in The Darling Buds of May?
Married to Michael Douglas. I can't remember his name. I can't remember her name. His name.
It was Catherine Zeta-Jones. What is the name of David Jason's character in Open All Hours? It was Granville. That's it, your 60 seconds. So, Joe, on the subject of David Jason, you scored 6 points. And at the end of that round, Jason's team is in the lead. Along with Ronnie Barker, David Jason starred in Open All Hours, which was set in a corner shop in Yorkshire. The series sadly ended when a Tesco Express opened next door. David Jason has starred in some of the best-loved British comedies of all time, including Porridge, Open All Hours and Only Fools and Horses. In fact, without him, UK gold would be Michael Parkinson on a loop worrying about his funeral expenses. Join us after the break to find out who will go through to the final of the Comedy World Cup. Yes. Now, have a think about this. One of our panellists was invited to stand for election to the House of Commons as MP for Yeovil. Which one was it? Welcome back to Comedy World Cup. Before the break, I asked you which of our panellists was once invited to stand for election to the House of Commons as the MP for Yeovil. Who's going to admit to that, then?
It's me.
Daniel?
No.
Really? No.
It was me.
It's got Nicholas Parsons.
Yes, I was. It was the Liberal Party then, not the Liberal Democrats, and Yeovil contacted me, the constituency party, and wanted to adopt me as their candidate. And I went down there and went round, toured the whole constituency, and they were very, very keen. And on the train back, I thought, you know, if you're going to make a success of this, you have to really work at it. Do I want to become a politician or do I want to remain an actor? And I decided that show business had more appeal than the House of Commons.
The problem is that you chose acting and you can't put as many expenses through. Do you know what I mean? As a politician, really fell out there.
I always felt sorry for that Tory MP, Mike Weatherly, who found out that his wife was a prostitute and he cried. And he came on TV, he goes, my wife was a prostitute and I had no idea. And he cried because he realised all the times they were making love, he could have claimed it back on expenses. That's why he cried. I felt sorry. I cried about that.
So back to the quiz for our What Happens Next round. I'm going to play our teams a clip from a well-known show, freeze it, and ask them, well, the obvious question. Omid's team, here's your clip. It's from French and Saunders.
I have no idea. I mean, I can guess.
I've never seen any of it. So if I were to guess from what I saw there, in the face or...
I think she smashes it in her face
or something along those lines.
What?
Don French smashes it into Jennifer's face. I think that's what happens. I think she's jealous that she's got it.
Yeah, and into
down
Don
her throat
French's
like that.
Face.
I think there might be something to do with that we've got the... Because cricket bails, these... It must be a massive cricket ball comes and smashes... It's something, the wagon wheels ends up in her face somehow, either by a cricket ball...
I'd say
or...
she just shoves it in her face, yeah. What I think happens.
And with Joe.
Are you guessing, or...
I vaguely remember something like that, she shoves it in her mouth.
So you're saying Dawn shoves it in Jennifer's face?
Yeah, that's what I think.
Let's see if Dawn shoves it in Jennifer's face.
Very different, very different. Very different. No way.
I'm afraid I can't give you that.
No way. Come on!
Jennifer very much shoved it in her own face.
But no, but there was motivation from Dawn.
Motivation is as maybe, but there was no shoveage.
We said, hang on a minute!
You said, and I pushed you for specificity.
We did! So we said that Dawn French causes a reaction.
No.
That's what we said.
Dawn shoved it in Jennifer's face. I'm sorry, but you do get a bonus question. So, Which comedy actor is Jennifer Saunders married to?
Adrian Edmondson.
Is the correct answer. Okay, I got something here. Jennifer Saunders has recently written the Spice Girls musical, although for legal reasons they may have to drop the word musical.
Big fan.
Diss the Spices.
Yeah, careful.
Jason's team, here's your clip. It's from Morecambe and Wise.
I think there's no more stairs left, and they climb down and then, very ungainly, help Penelope Keith down as well.
That's right. Oh, great. The step at the end.
That's the one. It's just a drop. It's like
and they have to help her down. That's right. And she gets down.
Yeah, there's no stairs, and then help her down.
Let's see if you're right.
Pardon?
It's a vertigo.
Just you,
that's wind, isn't it?
No.
Yes, Morecambe and Wise. Did you ever work with Morecambe and Wise, Nicholas?
Oh, yes, I was in their show, a guest in their show a couple of times. Yeah. I knew Eric very well from the Lord's Tavern. He was our president for many years. Oh. Absolutely lovely, lovely man.
I do feel like it's a bit Christmas now, though, when I see that. Yeah. I sort of feel like having a bit of like a Bailey's and then having a nap.
Here's your bonus question. When the famous conductor Andre Previn appeared on the Morecambe and Wise show, he accused Eric, who was at the piano, of playing all the wrong notes. What was Eric's reply?
Should I tell them?
Go on, Nicholas.
He went over to him and he did this. He said, I'm playing all the right notes, but not necessarily in the right order.
Wow, I like that.
That's absolutely correct. 1 point. All right. Standing. I've just been assaulted by Nicholas Parsons. I'm all a jigger. In its heyday, the Morecambe and Wise show was regularly watched by 28 million viewers. To get those sorts of audiences these days, David Beckham would have to be crowned king by Del Boy at the Olympic opening ceremony during a strictly tense penalty shootout Great British Bake Off. On ice. Time for another quick look at the scores as we approach the final round of this semi-final. It's very tense, as I tell you. Ahmed has 16, Jason has 19. So, there is quite literally everything to play for, ladies and gentlemen. It's the quick-fire round. So, I'm going to ask a series of questions that cover just about every area of comedy. Buzz in if you know the answer. 1 point for each correct answer, and the time starts now. Which 2011 film starred Kirsten Wiig as a reluctant maid of honour? Yes, Daniel.
Bridesmaids.
Yes, the correct answer. What exactly is Red Dwarf in Red Dwarf? Yes, Daniel.
It's the ship, is it not?
It's the spaceship, yes. On Saturday Night Live, who were the two wild and crazy guys? Yes, Daniel?
Garth and,
Steve Martin and Dan Aykroyd. Tracy Ullman, David Copperfield and Lenny Henry were stars of what 80s show?
Three of a Kind.
Jason, Three of a Kind's a correct answer. Everybody Hates Chris is a sitcom based on whose life,
Chris Rock.
Daniel? Chris Rock is correct. Whose latest book is titled I Hate Everyone, Starting With Me, Daniel?
Oh, no.
Yeah, but
Jesus.
It's not Jesus. Often mistaken, it's Joan Rivers. Captain Peacock, Mr. Rumbold and Mr. Spooner were all characters in. Omid? Yeah, I'm going to have to hurry you.
It's...
final score. Ahmed has 19, Jason has 20. So, going through to the Comedy World Cup final to face Johnny, Josh and Mick are Jason's team. Thanks to everyone for taking part, Jason, Paul and Nicholas. And let's hear it for our gallant losers, Ahmed, Daniel and Joe. This is... I'm David Tennant. This has been the Comedy World Cup. See you next week for the final. Good night!